If you like this video, why not subscribe?
Hey everyone, welcome back to the Frugal Filmmaker Tip of the Month. A short while ago, I uploaded a video called The Making of Hostages, which was a behind-the-scenes look at how I created the short film Hostages. Within that making of video, I included my animated storyboards that I used for the project, and after I did that, people were asking, well, how did you do that? How did you do the animated storyboards? What software did you use? I then revealed in a Q&A episode that it was with Sony Vegas Pro using a few simple tools. And people wanted me to show them how to do that. So that's what this episode is all about. If you're unfamiliar with a storyboard, it's basically a drawing of a frame of a shot that you want to put in your movie. An animated storyboard is the animation of that shot so you can get an idea, a better idea what it will look like. For this example, I'm going to use this storyboard. I'm going to animate it to do this. And just for fun, here's the actual shot, how it turned out. Okay, after you've scanned your storyboard and then brought it into your editor, you're going to bring it up to your timeline here. And then I'm using the pan crop tool first. This, whatever it's called in any other editor, you just have to figure it out. I think it's called Motion in Apple, Final Cut Pro. I'm not sure about Premiere Pro, but it's the tool that lets you zoom in and crop the image and animate it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to crop the image. Because we're going to be animating it, so you want space to move around in. So you just have to adjust your frame until you get all the black bars to go away. So there's your shot there, and you can see now if I were to animate just this, I could move around the image. This is how you do some of the animated storyboards, because you can, using keyframes, you can animate the heck out of it. But I want to be able to move the shoe here inside the key ring as the arrow indicates it is doing. So after I've cropped the image and I've given myself, you know, a little maneuvering room, I am then going to copy the shot and then put it on the timeline directly below it so it matches up. So now I've got a stacked shot. These are exactly the same. Then I'm going to go back into the pan crop tool, go down here and click on mask. I'm then going to create a mask using these little pen tool things here that goes around the shoe because I want the shoe to animate. So I'm just doing this. Now I know in some versions of Vegas there's no masking. I think Pro might be the only version that has masking. Of course it's the most expensive version, but some other editors might. You just need to mask that area. Now as I go back to position, you'll know, well actually let me go back to mask here. Notice that the mode is positive, and yeah, just that the area is grayed out. But nothing up over here in the preview window appears to have changed. But when I go back to position, and I move this around, notice now that the shoe is moving because I'm just basically moving around the masked area. So we want it to move forward and not reveal there's something underneath. Obviously that won't look very good for animation. So I'm going to start there where it looks normal. Then I'm going to move the cursor here over to where I want to drop a keyframe. And a keyframe will drop in Vegas as soon as you move something. So now when I slide the shoe forward, notice this doesn't have to be perfect. My drawings aren't very good, but it's just to get the idea across. Notice the keyframe was dropped. I'm going to right click on the keyframe and hit smooth so that it will be a smooth start and stop. And now when I play the clip, notice how it moves forward. And that's it. I mean, basically that's how I did all the animated storyboards in that video that you saw. And it's either, this is the most complicated version, everything else I was just zooming in or panning around on without doing masking. But if you want to move an object within the picture and not have everything else move, you need to do masking. So that's it, that's the easy way of doing it in Sony Vegas Pro, just using masking and the pan crop tool. This has been the Frugal Filmmaker Tip of the Month, we'll see you next time.